how long does it take you to successfully take over a ISIS member's account on Twitter?
Once I get the information I need, I can be in an account as fast as 60 seconds.
ISIS has been waging a cyber war online. Then there are the folks that are fighting against ISIS, and these guys aren't doing it legally. They're hackers. One of them I've been talking to for months, he goes by the name Wachula Ghost. That's his alias. Now, his latest move is he's been taking down hundreds of ISIS members' Twitter accounts and replacing the content with pornography and gay pride memorabilia. So I'm going to call him up and ask him why he's doing this, and also how easy is it to hack into the Twitter account of an ISIS member. Hello?
Hey, Lori, how you doing?
What exactly have you been doing with ISIS accounts?
Lately, we started hijacking their accounts, taking over their accounts, basically just to troll them, to annoy them and make fun of them, and take screenshots, phone numbers, IP addresses, the whole nine yards. So I have all that information on all the accounts I've ever taken. Then we got the idea, there were others that had the idea also, of spreading porn through the accounts.
And so why pornography?
We thought that putting the porn naked images would offend them. And I'm sure it's offended other Muslims, but that wasn't our goal.
Now that this horrific tragedy has happened in Orlando, you guys have been also putting up gay pride messages. Can you talk me through that?
I saw the news, and you know, you had all those people, those innocent lives that were lost, and all the people, everyone was mourning. And I just felt there was something I could do, so I took their images, their flags, And I left a message on a lot of the accounts in support of gay pride.
So how sophisticated are some of the ISIS members that you're kind of going up against?
Technically, I've seen 10-year-olds smarter.
Would you call yourself a sophisticated hacker?
I'd say you're average Joe.
What do you say to the government argument? Folks in national security will say, well, we keep these Twitter accounts up so we can monitor, and so we can, you know, get any clues as to who these people are and where they are, and taking them down actually does harm.
Whenever we take that account and we expose that information, it's out there. I've had a couple of different countries that have got cyber intelligence companies that have told me to keep it up, to keep putting that information public, because they are using it.
What in you causes you to wake up every morning, go to your day job, come home, and then hack?
It's time, I think, the world starts to stand up and starts doing their own part, or anything they can. We're trying to get them off social media. If the social media people like Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, if they would step up and do a little bit more to keep them offline, it'd help.
You don't believe that the government is doing enough? You don't believe that the social networks are doing enough?
If social networks were doing enough, we wouldn't be on there doing what we're doing. I get beheading images, I get threats, we're going to kill you, we're going to do that. And that's great, because they're focusing on me right now, and so that means they're not able to do something else.
Why is it so personal to you?
Sometimes you just have to stand up for what you believe in. If you want change, you have to make that change.
Even if it means doing something illegal?
Even if it means doing something illegal. If the change is for the good, it's got to be done.